Function generators are devices that make it possible to generate signals with different signal forms, frequencies, and amplitudes. The wide range of possible settings makes these devices indispensable in electronics laboratories at the latest when alternating signals are required. However, the voltage signal they output can be, besides a basic sine wave, a square or ramp wave, a pulse, or even noise. They allow us to output signals with various amplitudes, frequencies, offsets, phase shifts, and time durations. Many of them, like this function generator right here, also allow amplitude, frequency, and phase modulation. In this video, we will take a look into its various functions and different possibilities it provides us. In order to start up the function generator, you have to connect it to an electric socket with a power cable. The next step is to click on the power button and voila, simple as that. Let's have a brief look at the buttons available. On the bottom, we can see the power button and buttons for switching between the different waveforms and different channels. Above them, there are six blue buttons whose function changes as we switch between different settings. Their function is displayed above them here, and if we click on something else, they could provide completely different functions. On the right, we have the numbers pad, which is used to set values such as amplitude or frequency. So, for example, let's try changing the frequency of a signal to 2 kHz. We simply write 2 and choose the unit to be in kHz. The buttons above the numbers provide even more options, but we only want to explain the basics and we will not discuss their functionality. However, you can find the datasheet and the user manual of this function generator in the video description. On the top right, we have a spinning wheel, which is like a numbers pad used for changing the value of something. So let's change the frequency back to 1 kHz using the wheel. Around the wheel, there is a left and right button for moving the pointer between different decimal points. Last but not least, we have the two outputs of the two channels. The upper output is channel 2 and the lower output is channel 1. One of the most common mistakes when using the channels in a circuit is mixing up the two outputs. So mark that the numbering starts from the bottom up. Okay, so that was a lot of information, and it is not expected that you remember all the possibilities function generators offer from only watching a video. You need practical experience to get the hang of all the different tools. A good tip when you're using this model and you're not sure what a certain button does is just holding that button for a couple of seconds. This will display the help menu and explain the function of the corresponding button. Now let's take a look at how to output a signal. We want to see what the signal actually looks like, so we will measure it with an oscilloscope. We already covered the scope in two separate videos. The links are included in the video description. This wire right here is called a coaxial cable, and we use it to connect our function generator to the circuit, or in this case, only to an oscilloscope. We connect channel 1 of the function generator with channel 1 of the scope, and simply click on the output button to activate the output. If the function generator was just booted up and no signal parameters were changed, we will see the default channel 1 signal, which is a sine wave with a frequency of 1 kHz and an amplitude of 5 volt peak to peak. That is exactly what is displayed here on the oscilloscope. To change the signal form, simply click on one of the other signal forms available. Let's try the square signal. It is important to note here that even though something was changed, the function generator is still providing the voltage signal. This is the case regardless if the frequency, the amplitude, or whatever else changes. It only stops to output the signal if the output button is pushed once again. As you can see, the light switched off. You can always determine whether the function generator is providing some voltage by checking if the output button is glowing. Be aware of this, because you may have electric components in your circuit, like light-emitting diodes, that usually can't handle high reverse voltages. If you accidentally increase the voltage while the function generator's output is still active, some parts of the circuit could be damaged or destroyed. Okay, now that we've got that out of the way, let's try changing the amplitude of the signal. To change the amplitude, simply switch to the amplitude menu and use either the wheel or the numbers pad to set the wanted value. We can see that the oscilloscope notices and measures the amplitude changes as we spin the wheel. We can do the same with the frequency. We switch to the frequency menu and simply spin the wheel on the top right. As we increase the frequency, we see the waves becoming more frequent, no pun intended. By spinning the wheel in the opposite direction, the frequency of the waves becomes lower. We reached 1 kHz, and if we try reducing the frequency even lower, we can see that nothing on the oscilloscope changes and we hear a beeping sound from the function generator. This happens whenever we reach the maximum or minimum value of a given range. So in order to go even lower in frequency, there are two things we can do. We can either change the selected unit, for example from kilohertz to hertz, or switch to a lower decimal point that the signal generator is pointing at, and change that value with the wheel. Now we want to create a 5 volt peak-to-peak square signal with a frequency of 2 kHz. To have that signal at the output, we first click on the square button to set the signal form. Next, we select the amplitude, push number 5 on the numbers pad and choose the unit to be in volts. Finally, we change to the frequency menu and set the frequency to 2 kHz. Over here on the scope, we have a square wave with 5 volt peak to peak ranging from minus 2.5 volts to plus 2.5 volts. Now, if you have worked with an Arduino or logic circuits before, you know that they don't really like the negative voltages. So how do we output a signal without going below 0 volts? It's quite simple. We just have to add a DC offset to the AC signal. For our example, we need to add an offset of 2.5 volts DC to the signal in order to have a signal without negative voltage levels. Click on the offset menu and type in 2.5 volts. The signal now has exactly the same peak-to-peak value and the same frequency, but it ranges from 0 to 5 volts. The alternative is to use the high level and low level functions and set the values there. Let's use this method to have a sine wave with peaks at 0 and 3.3 volts. Last but not least, let's try outputting two signals at once. For this, all we need is another coaxial cable. We connect it to the channel 2 of the function generator and the second channel of the oscilloscope. Before outputting a signal, we first set the characteristics of the signal the way we want them. To change between the channels, press this button here. Now we are looking at the characteristics of channel 2. We'll change the signal to be a sine wave with 1 kHz frequency and an amplitude of 5 volts peak to peak. All that's left now is to click the output button. The oscilloscope is showing the two signals we specified before. You may be wondering why the signals are on different vertical levels, as if their zero value is not the same. This is just caused by the oscilloscope settings. We can simply change their vertical offsets to be actual zero by turning these two knobs. Now the amplitude difference is obvious, and it's pretty visible that the frequency of the signals is the same. But why do we see a phase shift? This is because the function generator doesn't automatically align the two signals to be in phase. To do this, simply click on the Align Phase button and the signals will align their phases. That's all the kickstart knowledge you need to handle a function generator. We have covered how to set amplitudes, frequencies, signal forms, offsets, and have shown all of these settings in a small example. After some experimenting with the function generator, you will be able to use various useful functions in no time. I am Ćazim with the Institute of Electronics. We hope you have learned something today, but anyways, thanks for watching.